Here we want to learn how it is that an enzyme is able to achieve its remarkable rate enhancement. Imagine a reaction taking place along a reaction pathway. The first question we want to ask is, where should the enzyme impart the greatest stability along that reaction pathway? Should it, for example, bring stability to the transition state structure, or should it try to more tightly bind the substrate? We're going to answer that question by looking at this kinetic model, where we're going to assume the enzyme and substrate are in a fast equilibrium to form an enzyme-substrate complex. We'll treat the enzyme-substrate complex as a unimolecular species that breaks down by a first-order rate coefficient, a rate process that's governed by the first-order rate coefficient kcat, yielding the enzyme and the product. That's the turnover event. The question that we want to ask then, should the enzyme bind the substrate more tightly, or should it bind the transition state that leads to the turnover process? We're going to answer that question by looking at reaction coordinate diagrams. We'll plot the progress of the reaction against free energy, and we're going to keep fixed the energies of the reactants, E and S, and what we're going to also keep fixed is the energy of the product, E plus P, and we'll vary then the energy of the enzyme-substrate complex and the transition state leading to that. A through D will be variations in those terms. We're going to call A the reference energy, and so in the case of A, what we're going to have is our reference point for the enzyme substrate. Everything will be compared relative to this lower dashed line for the enzyme substrate energy, and then we'll consider as the transition state energy reference point the upper dashed line. The activation energy for the reference energy is governed by E sub A, and we want to know in the cases of B, C, and D, which I'll tell you about, how E sub A changes. So for reference, relative to the reference point, let's look at the case where the enzyme binds both the substrate as well as the transition state structure more tightly. So in this case, we've dropped the E dot S below the reference point line, and by a similar degree, we've dropped the transition state energy below the reference point line. What's the result of that? Well, in this case, since they both fall by an equivalent energy, E sub A remains unchanged. The rate of the reaction is going to be constant. In case C, what we've done is only bind selectively the substrate more tightly than the reference point. We've left the transition state energy at the reference point value. So in this case, what we can see is that actually E sub A increases relative to the reference point. The rate of the reaction is going to decrease. And finally, in case D, what we have is a selective binding along the reaction pathway of the transition state leading to the turnover event. We're going to keep the energy of the enzyme-substrate complex fixed at the reference point value. In this case, we've lowered the activation energy, the rate of the reaction is going to increase. And so the main point that we can take away is that the enzyme needs to selectively bind the transition state structure for the turnover event, leaving the energy of the enzyme-substrate complex unchanged. We're going to use that model to develop what's known as the Michaelis-Menten expression of rate. And basically here what we're going to be looking at is how fast does the reaction proceed in terms of velocity of a reaction expressed by micromoles per second relative to the substrate concentration. We won't derive the Michaelis-Menten expression, but it's shown for you over here, where we're looking at the velocity against kcat, which was given in that previous kinetic model, concentration of enzyme, concentration of substrate in the numerator, and then in the denominator, something known as km. Km is the Michaelis constant. You can really think about it almost as a dissociation equilibrium constant. And so being a dissociation constant, the smaller the number, the more tightly the energy binds the substrate. And then also in the denominator is the term concentration of substrate. Kcat, by the way, also goes as another name. It represents the turnover number, which is the frequency at which product is produced, expressed in terms of moles of moles of substrate produced per mole of enzyme per second. So if you plot this curve on this plot, where we're using as the plot of substrate concentration a logarithmic plot, so each of these are powers of 10 that increment uniformly on the x-axis, what we see is the Michaelis expression shows this sigmoidal behavior. You can see it turns over at the top and plateaus out, and that's the point where the enzyme is all consumed with substrate. It's the saturation point. It represents Vmax. And in other words, at Vmax, you can imagine that the substrate concentration is going to be much larger than Km. Km is going to be usually expressed in micromoles, and so if we have thousands of times larger substrate concentration relative to the size of this dissociation constant, then we're going to basically let that value go to zero, and the expression for substrate concentration goes away. All we're left with is kcat times enzyme concentration. That's the fastest that the reaction can ever go, and it's at the limit of very high substrate concentration. Another point that we're interested in is what's Vmax over 2. That's the position, so if you just take halfway in between this saturation point, the halfway point, Vmax over 2, we're interested in knowing what that is. I won't derive this completely for you. You can do it yourself. But Vmax over 2, well, we know what Vmax is, and so Vmax over 2 is really just going to be kcat times the concentration of enzyme. And what we really want to know is, what's the substrate concentration at which we have a velocity of Vmax over 2? And so if we just set this as our velocity, velocity of Vmax over 2 equal to the Michaelis expression for velocity, kcat times the concentration of enzyme times the concentration of substrate over km plus substrate, you can go ahead and solve that for the concentration of substrate. And what you'll be left with is, at Vmax over 2, the concentration of substrate that brings about that velocity is just equal to k sub m. So when the substrate concentration is equal to k sub m, we're going to have Vmax over 2. Finally, at the low limit of substrate concentration, we basically have the situation where this term ends up going to zero, and we're left with the expression that is highlighted in the box. That would be the low limit of velocity for the enzyme-catalyzed process. Kcat over Km is, as you'll see on the next slide, reflects the enzyme efficiency. It's really a second-order rate coefficient. You can see that the way that it's expressed here, it looks just like a second-order rate expression, and so kcat over Km is going to have the units for a second-order rate coefficient where we multiply the enzyme concentration and the substrate concentration. We call kcat over Km the catalytic efficiency, and basically it's going to have an upper limit that's going to be controlled. Ultimately, there's a limit to how efficient an enzyme can be, and that limit is going to be how fast the substrate can diffuse into the enzyme active site. So there's an upper bound to how fast, to how large this kcat over km, the efficiency, can be. And that value tends to be, as you can see, for nature's very best enzymes, about 10 to the 8th. And so beyond that, a second order rate coefficient faster than 10 to the 8th has reached the point where the rate limiting step is the transport of the substrate to the enzyme active site. We can really never achieve a rate that's any faster than that. And of all of these enzymes, one that you might recognize that I've pulled out for you is the enzyme that's involved in the transmission of neural signals, acetylcholine being hydrolyzed into the corresponding carboxylic acid and alcohol. That's governed by acetylcholine esterase. The acetylcholine esterase is a reaction that we want to go very fast if we're going to propagate, turn on, and turn off nerve signals, and so it's on the order of this 10 to the 8th.